Alright. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera. How are you? Hope you all are fine. Today we will start the lecture with the first topic, which is properties of fluid. Before that, I would like to remind all of you to fill up the attendance form that I've placed in the WhatsApp group description. Alright. So let's start our lecture. As I mentioned before, the topic today is properties of fluid. Alright, these are the list of reference book used. You can get it at the library or online resources. In today's lecture, I will touch on the topic 1.1 until 1.4 only, which is introduction, continuum concept, unit and dimensions, and the last one is dimensional analysis. Then we look at the learning outcome. At the end of this lecture, you should be able to explain the continuum concept, apply the unit and dimension used for fluid mechanics, and the third one is carry out dimensional analysis using inductional method. Okay. Alright, as an introduction, we look at the definition first. What is fluid mechanics? The science that deal with the behavior of fluid at rest, or fluid static, or in a motion, or fluid dynamic, and the interaction of fluid with solids or other fluid at the boundaries. Okay, so maksudnya adalah fluid mechanics ni adalah satu science yang berkaitan dengan behavior of fluid. Okay, kita nak kenal pasti sifat, okay, sifat fluid sama ada dalam keadaan rest, tidak bergerak, ataupun in motion dalam keadaan bergerak. Okay, kemudian what is fluid? Okay, apa itu fluid? Fluid is substance in the liquid or gas phase. So sama ada kita punya substance tu dalam bentuk liquid ataupun dalam bentuk gas, kita consider dia sebagai fluid. A solid can resist an applied shear stress by deforming. Meanwhile, a fluid deforms continuously under the influence of shear stress no matter how small. So, kita tahu bahawa solid ni dia resistant terhadap shear stress. Okay. Tetapi kalau fluid pula, dia punya deform, perubahan bentuk dia akan berterusan berlaku apabila diberikan shear stress. Okay, for example, we see the deformation under for the rubber block, okay, as shown in the figure. Okay, deformation of rubber block placed between two parallel plates under the influence of the shear force. The shear stress shown in is that on the rubber and equal but opposite shear stress act on the upper plate. So apa maksud dia? So kita contoh, kita ada plate. Okay, ini adalah plate. Bila nampakkan ini adalah plate, and then ini juga plate. So plate ni juga kita panggil dia sebagai boundary. Okay, sempadan. So apabila kita gerakkan plate ni ke depan, sorry, apabila kita gerakkan plate ini ke hadapan, ke hadapan, so akan berlaku shear pada permukaan antara pada permukaan antara surface of rubber dengan surface of plate. So as you can see, the shear occurred on the rubber is this direction. Meanwhile, so kalau kita tengok dekat sini, dia kata the shear stress shown is that on the rubber and equal. Okay, so shear stress yang berlaku di antara plate, okay, plate dengan shear stress adalah sama. Sorry, plate shear stress yang berlaku di antara plate dengan rubber, shear stressnya adalah sama tetapi pada arah berlawanan. Maksudnya, shear stress pada rubber ni dia berlaku contohnya to the right. Okay, to the right, ke kanan. Tapi shear stress yang berlaku pada plate, pada permukaan plate bawah ni, dia adalah ke kiri. Nilai shear dia sama, cuma dia punya direction is opposite. Okay. Kemudian, quantum concept. Alright. What is quantum? Quantum concept, matter is made up of atoms that are widely spaced in the gas phase, yet it's very convenient to disregard the atomic nature of the substance and view it as the continuous homogeneous matter with no hole. That is a quantum. Quantum is valid as long as the size of system is large in comparison to distance between molecules. Engineering problems are normally concerned with the bulk behavior of fluid. Okay, apa maksud dia tu? Okay, so maksud dia, dia kata, for example, kita ada satu bekas. Kita ada satu bekas. Okay, dan bekas ini diisi dengan udara. For example, oksigen. Okay, so akan banyak ada molekul oksigen dalam ni. Okay. So, in the actual condition ataupun dalam keadaan sebenar, terdapat jarak di antara this terdapat di antara jarak molekul tu. Dalam keadaan sebenar, terdapat jarak. Tetapi, apabila kita mengambil kira jarak ni, kita punya analisis akan menjadi sukar. Sebab kita tak tahu jarak antara satu molekul ke satu molekul tu berapa jauh jarak dia. Jadi, kita akan buat assumption bahawa there is continuous and homogeneous with no hole. Maksudnya, kita akan consider ataupun kita akan assume bahawa molekul udara atau oksigen tu akan berada dalam keadaan rapat. Okay, so dia memenuhi ruang. Continuous and homogeneous. Maksudnya, dia continuous, dia berterusan dan dia homogeneous. Homogeneous means dia dia punya serakan adalah sama. Dia tak adalah bahagian atas banyak, bahagian bawah sikit. Tak. Kita akan assume bahawa oksigen, okay, for example, oksigen dalam bekas ni adalah continuous and homogeneous. Dan quantum concept ni hanya valid jikalau kita punya size, okay, the size of distance is smaller than kita punya bekas ataupun kita punya size of system. Ni kita namakan dia size of system. Kemudian dekat sini pun dia kata engineering problem are normally concerned with the bulk behavior. So, normally kita akan kira ataupun as an engineer, kita tak akan kira, for example, kita ada surface of water here. Okay. Surface of water, and then air itu akan mengalir. Okay, so we know that air adalah terdiri daripada H2O. Dan sebagai engineer, kita tak akan calculate berapa kelajuan hidrogen, berapa kelajuan oksigen, which is oksigen H2O. Tapi kita akan calculate berapa kelajuan ataupun velocity of the H2O itself. So, kita consider dia sebagai bulk behavior. So, kita akan kira dia secara keseluruhan. Okay. Ini maksud dia. Continue. Concept. The term you have to memorize or you have to understand is continuous and homogeneous with no hole. So, maksudnya dia adalah bersambungan ataupun dirapat-rapat dan dia adalah sekata. Itu adalah continuum. Okey, kemudian microscopic. Okey, microscopic or classical approach. Apa itu microscopic? Does not require a knowledge of the behavior of individual molecules and provide a direct and easy way to analyze engineering problem. Meanwhile, microscopic ataupun statistical approach based on the average behavior of large group of individual molecules. So, approach kita sekarang, kalau kita menggunakan konsep continuum, ini yang kita maksudkan tadi. Kita akan tengok dari segi microscopic approach. Kita akan tengok, kita tak akan tengok secara individual molecule. Okay, contoh yang saya bagi tadi, kita tak akan tengok kelajuan H. Kita tak akan tengok kelajuan oksigen. Kita akan tengok kelajuan as a bulk secara keseluruhan. Tapi kalau dalam mungkin dalam chemistry ataupun fizik, kita akan kira dari segi molekul. Okay, which is kita namakan dia sebagai microscopic. Ya, ini makroskopik. Okay, boleh ya? Okay, kemudian unit and dimension. So, seperti yang saya bagi tahu dalam introduction lecture, untuk subjek fluid mechanics ni, dia akan melibatkan banyak convert unit. So, you all kena mahir lah untuk convert unit. For example, daripada liter kepada ml, daripada meter cube kepada liter. Okay. So, fluid mechanics deal with a variety of fluid characteristic. Therefore, it is necessary to develop a system to describe this characteristic both quantitatively, which is dimension, and qualitatively, which is dimension, and quantitatively, unit. A physical quantity, for example, mass, length, force, pressure, is clearly defined by the numerical value and a unit. A physical quantity can be measured using a standard size called the unit. Unit provide a convenience and standardized measure of the dimension. Two commonly used unit system are English system and the metric SI. So, biasanya kita akan pakai unit SI lah. Okay, for example, kalau dari segi jarak, okay, dari segi length, kita akan pakai meter. Okay, meter. Kalau mass, biasanya kita akan pakai kilogram ataupun gram. Kita tak akan guna pound, for example. Right. So, these are the basic quantity. Kalau length, okay, saya dah bagi tahu tadi, kalau length kebiasaannya ataupun SI unit dia adalah meter. Kalau mass, SI unit dia adalah kilogram. Time, SI unit dia adalah second. Electric current, SI unit dia adalah ampere. Dan thermodynamic, temperature is Kelvin. Alright. So, I know you all memang dah familiar dengan unit-unit tersebut. Okay. So, ini daripada basic unit tadi, dia akan jadi derived quantity lah. For example, area kita tahu, area length times length, that's why kita dapat meter square. Okay. Kalau volume, okay, dia akan jadi meter cube. Density is kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Kemudian, frequency hertz, acceleration meter square, sorry, meter per second square. Alright. And then, kat sini ada kesilapan sikit ni. Sepatutnya kilogram meter per meter cube ataupun kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Dia. Kemudian force is Newton, pressure is Pascal, torque is Newton meter, velocity is meter per second. Okay. The dimension of the physical quantities relate the physical quantity to the basic quantities. The dimension of the physical quantity can be written as physical quantity. Okay, physical quantity tu apa? Physical quantity tu adalah basic. Okay. Primary dimension. Okay, yang ni adalah dimension yang utama. Kita ada mass, kita ada length and kita ada time. Okay, lepas tu kita ada secondary dimension. Secondary dimension ni datang ni daripada primary lah. So, for example, kalau nak dapatkan velocity, okay, untuk dapatkan velocity is equal to V is equal to Q over A. Dan A tu datangnya daripada mana? Datangnya pun daripada primary dimension. Okay, yang paling simple. Yang paling simple untuk secondary is kita dapatkan area. Okay, which is area. Which is area. Sorry. Area. Equal to for example length times width kan, which is length lah, meter, so you get meter square. So ini adalah secondary, so datangnya daripada primary. Okay, for example velocity length over time. Okay, so length over time, so length is primary unit ataupun primary dimension. T is primary dimension, so and then they can produce secondary dimension. So ni pun contoh pun sama. Untuk dapatkan force, force is equal to mass, okay, darabkan dengan acceleration. So acceleration, the formula is velocity over time. Kemudian pressure, pressure is equal to force divided by area. So force ni sama ada juga dengan mass time acceleration. Alright. So the unit is Newton and pressure unit is Pascal. Okay, ini adalah perbandingan untuk unit sistem. Okay, kita akan ada FLT sistem, lepas kita ada MLT sistem, English unit and kita ada SI unit. So biasanya kita akan pakai dalam dalam subjek ni kita akan pakai SI unit. Okay, so nanti boleh tengoklah. Saya rasa you all pun dah familiar kalau macam area ni adalah meter square. Alright, density is kilogram per meter cube. Okay, kemudian. Okay, lagi satu yang you all perlu tahu adalah factor by which unit is multiplied. So, for example, kalau kita tahu bahawa kalau kilo. Okay, kilo automatically kita tahu dia adalah 10 power of 3. Jadi, dia punya simbol adalah K. Kemudian kalau giga, then kita tahu giga is 10 power of 9. Okay, dia punya simbol adalah capital G. Dan seterusnya. So, you boleh tengoklah. Kalau mili, 10 power of negative 3. Dan dia punya unit adalah small m. Alright. Kemudian dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is the analysis of the relationship between different physical quantities, okay, yang kita dah tengok tadi, by identifying their primary dimension and unit. In engineering, all equation must be is dimensionally homogeneous. That is, every term in the equation must have the same unit. So kita tahu bahawa kalau kita nak selesaikan suatu masalah ataupun suatu calculation, kita kena pastikan unit ni adalah sama. If at some stage of the analysis we find ourselves in the position to add two quantities that have difficult unit, it is clear indication that we have made an error at an earlier stage. So maksudnya kalau kita dapati at the end, okay, at the end kita dapati terdapat dua unit yang berbeza, okey, dua unit yang berbeza, dan kita tahulah bahawa kita telah melakukan satu kesilapan. For example, maksud unit yang berbeza ni kalau length, okey, kalau length you punya unit mestilah meter, tapi kalau you calculate at the end you dapat meter, lepas tu lagi satu you dapat feet, so it is wrong lah. So checking dimension, dimension analysis can serve as a valuable tool to spot error. One of the method that can be used for dimensional analysis in Dichel method. Alright, for example, a commonly used equation for determining the volumetric flow rate, which is Q, a liquid through an orifice located in the side of the tank is given. Okay, so this formula you all akan jumpa dalam topik ketiga. Okay, dalam topik ketiga, which is untuk dapatkan flow rate. Ini for example, untuk dia kita nak tunjukkan dimensional analysis. Sorry, indice method. A is an area. Okay, A ni adalah area. G is acceleration due to the gravity. And we know the value is 9.81. And H is height of the liquid above the orifice. Investigate the dimensional homogeneity of this equation. Okay, dia suruh kita kenal pasti supaya equation ni mempunyai persamaan dari segi dimension. Okay, so dia punya solutionnya adalah, okay, tadi daripada formula ni kita tahu Q is equal to 0.65 A square root 2GH. Okay, and then kita tahu, kita kenal pasti dulu dia punya unit for each element. For example, okay, for example, ini adalah Q. Q kita tahu dia punya unit adalah meter cube per second. Okay. Q is meter cube per second. So kita tahu M ni apa? M ni merujuk kepada meter, which is dia adalah length. Dan S ni second, dia merujuk kepada time. Okay. So kita kenal pasti untuk area pula, area dia punya, kita punya unit adalah meter square. So meter is referring to length. Okay, and then sama juga dengan acceleration, which is meter over second square. Okay, which is meter length, T is time, second, and H is meter. And then kita substitute kan kita punya equation ni, Q dengan LT. Okay, L squared, sorry, L cube over T. Ini kita substitutekan. A ni kita gantikan dengan L squared. G ni kita gantikan dengan yang ini. Dan H kita gantikan dengan L. And then apabila kita selesaikan, kita akan dapati both side of equation have the same dimension. Therefore, the equation is dimensionally homogeneous. Maksudnya, di sebelah sini equationnya sama dimension. So, betul lah kita punya penggunaan dimension. Okay, so hopefully you all boleh try untuk tentukan sama, untuk tentukan dia punya homogeneity of dimension for this example. Okay, nanti kita akan discuss dalam kita punya next lecture. Ini pun sama, nanti kita akan discuss dalam kita punya next lecture. Alright, I think that's all for this this week punya lecture. Jika ada masalah, boleh contact saya ataupun boleh WhatsApp saya. No problem. Alright, that's all for today and thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.